6 o'clock, so I think we will make a start. Firstly, can I welcome everybody and members in the audience to the Pensions Committee. I should advise that this meeting will be webcast and a record retained on the council website for up to 2 years. By participating in this meeting, you are consenting for your name, the content of what you say, and your image to be broadcast and stored to the council website. If any member, officer, or member of the public addressing the committee has concerns for this, please contact committee services officer immediately. Thank you. For those at home viewing the webcast, I'd like to inform you that if you look above the video, you'll see a resources tab. Select this and a link to the agenda will appear on the right hand side. And this allows you to open the agenda in PDF format and follow the discussion and debate. Can I remind committee members and officers that they need to turn on their microphone when speaking, otherwise what you say won't be captured on the webcast. Can I also ask members to turn the microphones off when not speaking, just to avoid microphone feedback. Moving on to item number two, apologies. I have apologies from Councillor Martin Bond. Do I have anyone else that... No? Okay, thank you. Item number three, members' code of conduct and declarations of interest. Do members have any disclosable, pecuniary or any other interests in connection with any items on the agenda?
I'm a member of Merseyside Pension Fund and my husband's preferred member.
George, and then Brian.
My wife is a member of the committee. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, actually, my fiance is a member of the pension fund.
Andrew?
Member of the committee. Member of the pension fund. Member of the pension fund.
Cherry?
My daughter's a member of the pension fund.
Okay. And I should also declare that my son's a member of the pension fund. Paulette?
I'm a member of the pension fund.
Thank you, Paulette. Sorry, John.
I am a member of the pension fund as well.
Thank you, John. Okay, moving on to item number four, minutes, pages 1 to 10. If we can approve, and I know Pat's got a question, so we'll align with Pat the minute if that's okay. But after that, if we can then approve the accuracy of the minutes held on the 11th of December 23. Over to you, Pat.
Thank you very much, Chair. Just one item arising from the minutes. At the bottom of page 3, in response to one of the questions we received last time, you said that I would ask the proposed Responsible Investment Working Party to look into the nature and extent of the pension fund's investments in companies connected with the defence trade. Now, I know that there's been further work on this since the committee last met, so I was wondering if you could provide an update on progress in this regard, and when the Pensions Committee will receive details of such investments and the outcomes of any engagement work with relevant defence companies. Because obviously there are a lot of people here tonight, I'm sure they'd be interested to know how we're going to proceed on this going forward. Thank you, Chair.
Thanks, Pat. And yeah, the Responsible Investment Working Party, we have met now twice, and it's cross-party. I think to give you a date as to when we're going to have an answer, it's too soon as yet, because as you say, there's a lot of work to be done. But I'm going to ask Peter to come in and give some more detail on the actual work that we're doing.
Yes, thank you, Chair. As you say, the first meeting of the Responsible Investment Working Party took place on the 19th of February, and a number of reports were received about that working party, principally around the fund's stewardship activities. The fund is seeking to become a signatory to the stewardship code by the end of the year. But there were papers also on the application of the stewardship code and the development of an engagement framework. And the fact is that...
I'm sorry, Peter, can you just go? Is there a problem? Tell me.
Chair, we've got an area for